So really, my job is really to show you from a clinical standpoint how this thing works and why I use it. I've been using it since September of 2019. I am a KOL for them, and I'm also on the clinical advisory board. So I know a little bit about the robot and also the future of what's coming. Some things I can't even tell Jay because he doesn't know. So I'd have to kill him. And some of you may want that, actually. So I'll tell him. I really would like to just thank Roe Dental for having me. Thank Neosis for letting me speak on behalf of their company. So I practice in Knoxville, like you said. My practice is 35 years old. I've been there for 23 years. I've been placing implants for 19 years now. I started placing implants at Midwest Implant Institute just down the street from you guys. And actually, I'll be there tomorrow. That's why I'm not in Cleveland tonight, because I got to be in Columbus tomorrow. And I can only take so much of Ohio State people. So just not going to come up until I need to. And so I place about 200 implants a year before I bought Yomi. And now we're doing about 350, close to 400. I'm in a group practice. There are five dentists in my facility, 16 chairs, getting ready to add a few more, have about 20 chairs or so, and a couple of different locations and things. So I'm kind of the surgeon for the group. I am a GP, and I'm a wet glove practicing dentist. I do composites, crowns, all sorts of stuff. So I hope that's what most of this crowd is. Really, and I think Jay may have gone over this, I got to tell into him, but you know, when we're doing implants, we basically have these modalities: free-end surgery, which is what I learned, 18, 19 years ago, static guided surgery, started doing those 10, 12 years ago, Simplant software and different labs making guides for me. And then the navigational surgery came along, XNAV, which is a good product, very different than what we're doing. It's not robotic. It's more suggestive type surgery versus robotics. And what robotic offers us is a true haptic guidance. And so it truly allows us to guide the drills, both in position, angulation, and depth without being able to come out of that plan, which to me is pinpoint accuracy and significant safety for our patients. And hopefully by the end of this evening, you'll see why I believe that's to be true. All right, so advancing my slide here. So Jay just went over basically what the Yomi is. And so we've got the driving station, which is the laptop on the left. You've got the screen in the front, which is for the surgeon and the clinical assistant, chairside assistant to look at. You've got the arm, which is down in the center. And that is a very lightweight arm that attaches to the patient, which he talked about. That is the magic wand. That is the magic sauce. And if it wasn't for that arm, we would still be doing just navigational. And then, of course, your robot arm on the right, which is an incredibly strong arm. You cannot manhandle it. I've tried it. It is it's basically a shrimp arm, which is the same arm that they put windshields on cars in Detroit. So if that's the same technology, and this thing moves up and down, and then the robot arm goes over the patient, and so you can get the position of the drill where you need to. So why robotics and implant dentistry? Well, you know, we're looking for efficiency. And so if you're looking at same day surgery, somebody comes in with a broken lateral incisor, they can leave my practice with a fully guided surgery, with a fully guided implant in place in 45 minutes or less. You can't do that with surgical guides. You certainly can do it freehand, but it's not guided. And if you've done immediates, sometimes it's hard to get that implant in the exact position you want because of skiffing or whatever. And you got the burr bouncing around and chattering and things like that. Minimally invasive, certainly you could try flapless free-handed. I wouldn't suggest you do that. I know surgical guides do that. And certainly we can do that robotically. Digitally integrated workflow, freehand, it's all analog. It's your eyeballs and your hands. Surgical guides are definitely digital. At least they should be today. Shouldn't be doing any more analog, just the accuracy's not there. And then obviously our workflow is purely digital. Physical guidance, and so obviously none with freehand, you do with surgical guides, and you do with surgical robotics. visual and audio guidance. I really like this. I like the fact that you can look at that screen and you can tell where that where your drill is inside the anatomy based on your CT image. And so that's with complete and dynamic. We'll talk about that in a minute, not so much with Yomi Go, but you also get that audio feedback. And so when we're in the right position, you know, we get an audible beep. When we go to depth, we get a triple beep. And so, you know, after a while, if you do IV sedation, it's like the sound of that EKG beep, beep, beep. When it changes, you know, same thing with this, you know, those beeps have become secondary to me. So I know exactly what those beeps mean without even having to look at the screen or anybody to tell me what's going on in the room. I know. So that visual and audio is a big deal. Standard drill kit's a big deal. I use VersaBurrs for most of my implants. 90%+ of my cases are done with VersaBurrs, and I don't have to buy anything fancy. You know, when you're doing guides, especially stackable guides, you got to get long drills sometimes to get through there. And sometimes you can't get it in certain areas of the mouth. And we all know that's an issue. Plus your armamentarium, the drill kits are expensive and you got to use them quite a bit as far as having to change your drill bits and things like that. So you have this ongoing expense with those different drills. And then being able to change, you know, one of the cool things about robotics is that we can change the plan right in the middle of a case if need be, if the bone's soft or whatever. And I actually have a case I'm going to show you tonight where I did that. And you can't do that with surgical guide. If the implant doesn't go as planned, the guide's worthless to you. Obviously, freehand, you can do whatever you want. And then visibility, which you'll see on our full arch cases, the way that the Yomi Link bone works, we're able to visualize the oral cavity. We can see the mouth. We can see airway. If you do IV sedation like I do, you know, your airway's not compromised and you really can't see. So, this is my implant coordinator, Carol. She's been working with me for 23 years. She actually was the assistant that I took with me to the Heller's place over in MII. So she's been with me for a long time. And I really want you to hear her words of about this robot and kind of what it's done for us.
The transition has really been great, actually. We had a little bit of a learning curve to begin with. It was new to everyone, and so there were a lot of things for all of us to learn, but because of Dr. Griffin's excitement over bringing this technology to our office and being able to implement it for our patients, it caught on like wildfire with our team.
So, I mean, the excitement, really, I was excited when I learned about it, but you know, getting something new technology. You know, a lot of times us docs, we come back from a meeting and we buy a widget, we bring a widget in the office and we stick it in the corner and don't use it. This was really exciting for the team, exciting for my office, exciting for the patients. And so it's really been a nice approach for us, just really building our practice internally without really having to market it. And you know, being the first one in Tennessee, we were able to kind of capitalize on that. And you know, when we're using technology, especially in the robotic world, because medicine has been using it for so much, you know, we're seen as very innovative. We're seen as thought leaders, et cetera. And so it really did a nice job helping us get going. And one of the things in my practice is when we present an implant to a patient, our assumption is that we're going to put it in robotically, that we're going to use the robot. There are instances where we're not able to, but we are going to attempt every case with the robot simply because it's accurate and the safety for the patient. So it's not an option really for us. It's the way we do it. And that's the way we brought it into the practice. And so we've got three different options of workflow. One of these is very new, but I'm going to kind of go through them. So the complete workflow is what I'm accustomed to, and it's what I do the most. And so when a patient comes in, we take a CBCT right off the bat for our diagnosis and treatment planning. So we do that on the front end before we start surgery. That does a couple of things for me. It allows me to plan the case. It also allows me to keep my inventory low because I know what implants I'm going to need for the particular cases. Instead of having 100 implants in stock, I've probably got 15 maybe. I just don't keep a whole lot in stock. So after we take it in an original scan and plan, a patient comes in, we place the link, we call it a splint in this, but it's the link. And then we send the patient to the CT machine with a fiducial array, which I'll show you in a minute. Patient comes back. You can plan it then, which is also called dynamic, but ours is already planned. We then attach the tracker arm to the patient and then proceed with surgery after you register your landmark. And then after the implant's done, once I finish placing the implant through, with the robot, we remove the splint. So that's the complete workflow. The second one is called Go. And again, this is brand new. I've only done one case with it so far, but basically the patient comes in, you put the splint in their mouth, you set them in the chair, you open up the, you take your handpiece that's attached to the robot. And when you place the implant or the drill bit then to where you want to put the implant, and you decide where you're, just like if you were freehanding, where you decide you're going to make your initial osteotomy, it will remember that position. And then from that point on, it is guided. And so you can, as you do your subsequent drills, it stays in that location that you decided you were going to do. And you can change that. You can change it as you go about surgery, but it really is important for depth, especially in posterior mandible, posterior maxilla with the sinuses. If you're really worried about depth control, that's really going to be good for you. Once you get your angulation right, it locks it in. And then if you're doing multiple implants, you can then parallel to that first implant. So it'll keep them parallel together. And the third option is dynamic, which is basically place the splint, send the patient to the CT. They come back. You then attach a tracker arm. While they're attaching the tracker arm and getting it registered, you can plan the surgery or plan the case right then and there and then perform the surgery. So not that much different than complete. Complete's really just plan it on the front end. So complete and dynamic are pretty similar. We've got a flow chart that kind of compares the three. For the sake of time, I'm not going to beat you over the head with it, but basically the complete is where we do a pre-op CT. And so that allows me to plan it and allows us to see the anatomy on the screen while we're doing the surgery. So complete and dynamic are going to be similar. With Yomi Go, you don't have to have the CT data on the screen. You're simply doing freehand. Once you decide your position, the implant, then it remembers that position and stays locked in that position, both in angulation, buccal lingual, mesial distal position, and your depth. And so again, complete allows for preoperative planning, and that doesn't happen for Go, but you can do you can have an imageless technique. And then with dynamic, you can kind of plan it intraoperatively if you want. With complete, you can see the anatomy on the screen. With Go, you don't. You just get this haptic guided position of your drill. And again, with dynamic, you can see it. With all three, you can change the position, size, and system of the implant during the procedure and still maintain guidance. You are going to have the same robot-assisted type surgery with the haptic guidance, the visual and audio feedback in all three. And then one of the things that, especially my oral surgeon buddies, is they want to sedate people right off the bat. And so they're not as concerned about pre-planning as I am as a general dentist. And so they also don't like general anesthesia, having to wake them up, send them to CT and come back. So it's kind of a workflow thing for surgeons is who uses the Go the most. I use complete the most. I don't have a problem. And I do IV sedation. I don't have a problem doing everything I need to do before I do sedation. So, and I'll even show you a case where we did the edentulous Yomi link bone with just oral sedation. So here's my setup. A lot of people look at the robot and think, gosh, that thing's huge. It's not going to fit in my room. I've got a bunch of stuff in this room. There's cameras, overhead cameras, lateral cameras, bunch of stuff. And that room is really small. This was built in the 80s. It's only eight and a half, 9 feet wide. So I don't have a ton of room, and it fits just fine in my room. The setup again is pretty typical. This is just the planning. It's very similar to any of the other planning softwares you've used. You can trim out the data you don't want. You get your occlusal planes right to help your planning. You can import an STL file to show the restoration that you're planning so that you can be a fully digital workflow. You can mark your nerves. You can mark your sinuses. And again, this is just a similar, just the planning of the case. And again, very similar to all the other implant planning software that's out there. Again, marking your nerve, the full library of implants, whatever implant you use, it's going to be in there. If not, they'll get the library for you. But now I think it is about every implant. I don't know. I've never heard of any that's not in there.